I have three very different yet similar stories to tell you today. The first one is about a young girl who was a really boring, monotonous, and adult speaker. This young girl joined her house debate team in grade 7 and in front of the whole audience stammered during the entire speech. This young girl picked herself back up and went on stage again in grade 8 and grade 9. To no one's surprise, she failed miserably. Stammering, not confident, not moving, boring. My second story is about a lady who was diagnosed with breast cancer on the 4th of July 2016. After various consultations, she went on to battle her cancer with 8 thorough sessions of chemotherapy and 30 sessions of radiotherapy. In the middle of her course, she failed to keep up with her treatment. Not only did she lose hope, but her family and friends had too. These sentiments were also shared by the hospital. My third story is about a gentleman who had a fantastic idea of a scientific discovery. In his lifetime, he attempted his invention various times. Not only did he fail to materialize the creation of his mind, it is recorded that he failed far more than any other scientist in history. Take note of the words I used repeatedly, which is failed. These three individuals, the young girl in school, the lady with cancer, and the inventor, failed in their attempts to achieve their various goals. Now you must be wondering that if all these individuals have failed, then why am I mentioning them to you today? What is their story? And is it any different from our own or ones we hear every day? If we think about them, they're not that unique. Many young individuals find skills or subjects that they are naturally weak in and make up for them in other areas. We lose many individuals every day from devastating diseases and illnesses like cancer. And there are so many cold cases when it comes to scientific discoveries. Success in this field is more rare than failure. However, maybe why we should discuss these three individuals is because their stories are not yet complete. The gentleman in the third story is the very famous Thomas Alva Edison. It is stated that he failed over 1,000 times in his attempt to create the light bulb, but his attitude towards failure is simply revolutionary. Edison has gone down in history for his very famous quote, "I didn't fail 1,000 times. I found 1,000 ways of how not to create the light bulb." The lady in the second story is none other than the beautiful lady sitting right in the audience, my mother. She bore... Thank you. She bore 8 harsh chemotherapies, one after the other, killing each and every cell in her body, be it good or bad. She then went on to radiotherapy that gave her a 3-degree burn. But look at her today. It has been a year and a half that she is a survivor. She persevered, although at a point it seemed impossible. And that girl who failed miserably on stage 3 continuous times is a speaker right before your eyes. Me. My name is Muhaimina Janmohamed. Would you believe if I told you that from grade 10 to grade 13, I have received 14 best speaker awards? Yes, that's me today. I was very bad at public speaking, and you already heard how many times I failed. But here I am today, after 100 failures, still trying to better myself each day. Who thought that a girl who would stammer in just an inter-house debate would be standing here today on this platform giving a TED talk? The common thing amongst all three of us was that we did not count our failures as strikes or losses or setbacks. We did not believe that it was better to call quits than to try again. We never thought that another try was not worth our time. We did not accept that this life, this goal, this invention was just not meant for us. Most importantly, we did not believe in the world's most dangerous phrase, third time's a charm. We've all heard this phrase before, right? Some people apply it to simple luck of the draw scenarios, while others apply it to ambitions and projects. I'll try at least three times, but after that, I'll know it was just not meant for me. When we think about failure and success, we view these two things as complete separate entities, as distinct as an on-off switch. You either persevered or you didn't. Today, I stand here not to say that you all can do it if you try hard enough, nor do I stand here to say that every challenge is surpassable with the right attitude. Today, I stand here to state that success and failure are not opposites, but merely stepping stones along the same path. That the very definition of success itself is repeated failure. That third time's a charm is nothing but a hoax. Let us now go back to the original three stories. These three individuals experienced failure in their own ways so many times. But these moments never discouraged them from continuing to make their way towards achieving their goals. This should show us a particularly different view of failure that we don't commonly see. Failure, in their eyes, was a stepping stone towards success, a feeling of growth or independence, or simply, oh, I'm getting there. With each step in the right direction, the others deemed bad. If I would have given up after my third failure at public speaking, then I wouldn't have been here today. I would have been in any other corner of the world watching a different TED Talk thinking, I remember when that used to be my dream. If my mom did not persevere even after reaching her breaking point, then she wouldn't have been amongst us here today. If Thomas Alva Edison did not have the simply great attitude towards failure, then he wouldn't have been America's greatest inventor. The first key may fail. The second key may also fail. And you might think that the third one would work. But this wasn't the case with us three individuals. None of our keys unlocked our success in our third attempt. Look at us today. I am confidently standing in front of you all. My mom is healthily sitting in the audience, and Thomas Alva Edison is one of the greatest inventors. How many of you have tried to achieve a goal and after repeated failure of about three failed attempts given up? What if you tried the fourth time and found yourself successful? What if your fourth time would have been your victory? What if your fourth time would have been a conquest? Unfortunately, it is always going to be a what if until you actually get up and give it another try. And maybe your fourth won't be successful, nor may your fifth or your sixth, but each step is an actual attempt to better yourself and to learn more about who you are and what you are capable of. In order to succeed in life, one must accept failure as part of life, because behind every successful person, there are a thousand stories of failure. Always remember that the number of times you failed does not tell you how much success you've had, but the number of times you tried does tell you how much you have grown. Thank you.